I kind of like just... I know it doesn't make a difference. I felt like annoying this guy for giving him one report at a time. Since he wanted it done so quickly, this is a slower way to do it. Hand it over a few report. I see. Everything seems okay. Now go upstairs, hand this to the director of the lab. Forte was entrusted with 1F report. An important experiment is going on upstairs. Don't interrupt them, okay? Now go deliver the reports quickly. But what if I interrupt them by delivering the reports? I can't go through that. I forgot to look at the others. Well, I'm sure if we couldn't read one, we couldn't read the others. But these are actually books. Oh, I see it. Work progress report for the entire first floor at Cleda's Wood Soldier Factory. Oh, he put all the reports into one. Got it. He has concatenated and collated them. I just want to see if anyone says anything different now that we did that. Something terrible is being made upstairs. They're giving wood soldiers magical powers by incorporating a strange stone inside. A strange stone? I don't know if she said that before. These people saying the same thing. You're going to delivery the report upstairs? Yes, is he? Oh, look. More fortune cookies. The fortune is going to say your robots got blown up. Or your factory will cease to function, either one. What are you doing here? Bothering you? I cannot allow you to go basement. No go basement. It's all the same. Some of the guards say new things, though. The second floor is the research lab. Read that. Did you finish what the director asked you to do? I won't answer you. Instead, I'll just walk. Actually, run away. Alright, let's go. Let's go. You don't have freedom to go outside. Where are you going? Up? I'm going to deliver a report to the director on the second floor. Okay, you may pass. Come right back. You're going to delivery the report to the director upstairs, right? Yes, we're going to delivery the report. Springing up from the stairs. Oh, I was like, I thought my gamepad was like messed up. I'm like, I stopped moving. Ada says, Forte. Ada, what happened?
I found him. He was here.
What? Capri. Huh? Really? Come, this way. But I have to deliver the 1F report. Capri. Oh, damn. He's got some strange arms and legs attached to him, but that's Capri. Ada, calm down.
Hey!
What is she doing? Oh, there's Ambassador Breger. And how is the modification going? Subordinate says, Sir, the arms and legs are nearly complete, but...
Hide, says Forte.
What's this head?
The head is the problem, sir.
If we remove the head, we can't control the arms and legs, so we left it there, but as long as the head is installed, it won't recognize any human as an enemy.
What?
Then this is just a useless piece of junk. We use this as a template to mass-produce the wood soldiers. Now, we must modify this unit and make it the ultimate weapon. That will make the Emperor very pleased. Please forgive me, sir. I promise that we will complete the ultimate wood soldier. We must create the ultimate wood soldier army using the wood soldier equipped with a resonant stone and the wood soldier by Rosette modified as the two center pillars. Or Rosette. Oh. Oops. I almost saw us.
He looks suspicious, though.
Oh, Kapuri, says Ada.
Ada.
Ada says, we have to save Kapuri somehow. Not now. Let's calm down and think of a way.
Kapuri.
Now is not the time. Let's go and collect some information first. If we're going to make a distraction, we need to keep contact with Grandpa. We also need to deliver the reports to the director in the lab, or they'll be suspicious. Let's go.
Don't worry. You got your chance.
Okay.
Ada joins the party.
Kapuri, hang on. I'm coming to save you.
Alright.
So I was supposed to deliver to that guy. But we'll hit him last. The researcher says, you don't look familiar. Are you a new recruit?
Yep, new recruit.
You brought the 1F report? Then hurry up and give it to the director.
Never, it's mine.
The operation on this side is going as planned. Good, good, says Breger. Well, we definitely can't get in there. I was curious if he'd let us go downstairs. Alright, let's give it to the guy. Okay. It's like, how do I get around?
Ah, the report from downstairs?
Forte handed over the 1F report.
I see. Good job. Now go back to work.
Dismissed. Go back downstairs.
Work well.
Work well.
If you're done with your task, go back downstairs.
But I want to talk to you.
Alright, let's see if Breger's saying anything new.
Not really.
We're done for today. You line up too.
Oh, do we go back to the town then?
This completes our operation for today, says the director.
Yeah, where are they housing these people? Or do they get to go home?
Remember, don't engage in suspicious activity, okay? If any of you act suspiciously, we're going to punish all of you for it.
Now go back to your barracks.
Oh, there's barracks?
That's right, we haven't had a chance to look around this town. Or whatever. Compound.
Disperse!
What if we want to glom together?
Come to the exchanger later, says Palman.
We all know it's Palman.
Exchanger, says Forte.
What the hell is an exchanger? Well, I think we'll just have our leave now.
Hey, Forte, if we try and leave now, we'll get caught.
All right, then.
What are you doing here? Were you lost? Where's the bathroom? I'm sleepwalking? Those excuses won't work, okay?
How about my dog ate the homework? There's the barracks for sleeping people. Ooh, here's a chest. Orb of Ocean 85. Good year. I can't go behind that one. Eighty-five is an image of an ambassador Berreger shouting. Yeah, what he does best, I guess, right?
Go back to you stations.
Another chest.
Orb of Ocean 58.
Okay, so 85 and 58. I see. I don't know why I have some kind of mental block with this. I was going to the wrong place. 58.
Image of Ada shouting.
Nothing hidden back here, right?
What are you doing? You're not planning on escaping, are you?
Yeah, something like that.
Forte, we need to check a little bit more, says Una.
Need to check more?
It's not good to wander around here when it's not operation time. We'd be in trouble if the guards find us, says McBean. We shouldn't go in the factory, says Una.
Try to, anyway. Wasn't there a guard just right there? Oh.
What are you doing wandering around here?
Wandering around here?
Are you planning on escape from here? Go back to your station.
Work's over. I'm going back to my station.
We've been dismissed. We've been told to disperse.
So, I am dispersed.
What are you doing? Get out of the way!
No.
Alright, so those are the barracks.
No. Come back when I do.
Alright, let's see if there's any... Right. There's a doll knight here. I think. There is! Doll Knight 21, The Design of Puppeteers. It's the second to last volume.
I got it! Let's do the exchange. I would have to buy that other armor if the guy's selling it. Let's see what else he has, though. Anything we might need? That's okay. Well, we don't have enough for her charge spear. We can get her that armor. Unless we find something better for someone else that we do use in combat. Yeah, that's it. They sell the same things as in, what do you call it? The town we were just in. Sheet armor for Ada. This way, we can swap her out when someone gets injured. That kind of thing. Okay, so the defense going up 7 points to 148. Ta-da! And now we will sell the chain shroud. Good. Another barracks. Are there any other... What's this place? Trade items? You mean buy items? Horn helmet? It looks like this is all accessories. This is an accessory store. So we have the horn helmet. Cool looking helmet with horns makes you feel cool. Increasing your attack power. Guard jacket. No sleeve jacket with lead sewn in. A little heavy, but offers more protection. Silver ring. Beautiful moon colored ring that shines. Increases protection against spells. Pointed hat. Sleek striped hat that makes you feel like a witch. Increases spell power. Lucky key ring. Silver chain braided key ring that makes you very happy and increases critical rate. Resurrect ring. Yeah, we've seen this one before. Purifying charm. Charm purified in sacred water. Neutralizes poison. Stimulant charm. Charm giving off a stimulating aroma. Clears your clear. What? Clears your clear. No more drowsiness. Well, I'm glad it clears my clear. I mean, need my clear cleared, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if I need any of that. What am I using now? Fighting band. I don't know what it does. I can't hit a key to, I'd have to unequip it to see, but... There's nothing I can do to... Jolly keyring. Hairpin, dotted ribbon. Flip cake, fighting band. Yeah, I'm not sure. Well, it drives me crazy. We have to take the stuff off. Fighting band Jolly Keyring. Is you also selling a Jolly Keyring? You're selling a Lucky Keyring. Jan and Rick would benefit. So would Ada. So we make Jan and Rick. We only buy one. That stinks. But it would increase Janarik's hit to 134. I don't know what. That was pretty good. Does that mean we're taking off the red bandana then? I lose 2 defense. Yeah, sorry, Ada, you're not gonna get that new weapon anytime soon. Yeah, look what it does for Jan and Rick. Well, maybe I should buy the horn helmet. Attack goes up by 10. And defense 116 by 2. None of rills. Oh, you have to buy them with rills. Ugh. So we can exchange back? Wait. Oh, can we why can't we exchange gents for rills? I mean, rills for gents. I can't get any of this stuff right now then. Who the hell are you? Oh. You're someone we have to talk to. I'm going to talk to you last. So it looks like there's only 3 buildings. There's that one. The factory. And the barracks. I purposely saved the barracks because I figured we were going to go to sleep or something and that'd be it. You have to remember that. Oh, let's put this back on. Can we wake these people up? I can't sleep here when everyone else is forced to take up my slack. Bane. Batman's enemy. I'm Bane. Kurutsu says it's over. I can't move, much less work. I haven't eaten anything good lately. Gimiru says, man, I can't go on. Let me rest a bit. I'll work right after I get up. Do you want a bed for the night? Let me rest a bit. Takuto says, you should rest a bit too. Too much work will wear you out. Mina's mother. I'm so worried about our daughter we left in Gezalg. Oh, I wonder if they're living okay. If they're living okay. Mina's father. My wife is so sick. Stay with me, honey. Mina is waiting for us in Gezalg. Alright, now we'll talk to this guy. Ricci says, are you Mr. McBain in party? Yes, says McBain. Please, this way. There aren't any soldiers here. Don't worry. Mr. McBain and his party are here. Looks like they were expecting us. Oh, that's right, because of Palman. You come all the way out here, huh? Says Palman. Did you come chasing after Arya? It's Mr. Palman, says Forte. What are you doing here, Palman? You know this person, asks Ada. McBain says, I heard that there's a person named Ector hiding in here, but is that person... Yes, I am Ector. The Royal Prince of Numeros is... says Una. Oh, you heard from the Elder of Gezalg, huh? Says Palman. Yeah, I remember being born in a family like that, but it doesn't matter now. Palman, where's Aria? Says Forte. I heard that Xenon captured Aria, he says. She was probably taken to the capital city of Pukasus. But all things must be performed in order. We can't just leave the Wood Soldier Factory in Cleda alone. We have to first destroy this place and free all the people from Gezalg and Cleda. If it were Aria, I don't think she'd abandon everyone. That's why I'm going to fight. Batty says, Sir Ector. McBain says, oh, I see. And what is all this construction? I'm connecting a passage to the underground power control room. The hallways are closely monitored by the soldiers. We'd like to get close to the heart of the factory secretly and then stop the function of the factory. But the stone layer is harder than we thought, and it's taking a long time. Oh, McBain, use a special punch. Everyone is working on this after taking a short nap after a full day of forced labor from the soldiers. Everyone is at the limit of their physical power. Everyone's tired, says Rigi. We have so many sick people. Batty says, at this rate, we'll end up with people who don't have the energy to escape, even if we succeed. Well, that would stink. Roraru's father says, if I can go back to Gezalg, I know a really good medicine. The royal herb that Grandpa Runald makes would give us all the energy we need. Royal herb? Asked Forte. Yeah, it's a special drink that Grandpa Runald makes. It contains honey and garlic and many other things. It tastes really bad, but it can get rid of any degrees of fatigue. Palman says, but we can have the soldiers find out about such a medicine. If they find out, they'll make us work even more. If possible, we'd like to continue digging the hole by pretending a few of us are sick. If we can sneak the royal herb to you, says McBain, it'll fix all of our problems then? We'll go and get it for you, says Forte. That's true, Una says. The soldiers still don't know our faces yet. They won't be suspicious, even if we're gone for a while. If you can bring some, it'd be great, says Palman. To tell you the truth, I was planning on asking you to get them when I first saw you. The problem is, Ada says, how do we get out of Cleda? We have a portion of the fence destroyed and camouflaged, says Palman. You can get out through there. Okay, let's get this done, says McBain. We should go and tell the Elder of Gezalg and Kiska the good news, too. We'll go and get the royal herb from Grandpa Runald, and we'll be right back. Just hang on. Thanks. We'll be ready to destroy the factory equipment by the time you get back. Wow, huh? The escape route is just on the west side of the exchanger. It's camouflaged, so it's hard to find. Check the walls. Okay, let's talk to the rest of these people. Ronald's son. My father's royal herbs really work. It works so well that you end up with a bloody nose if you drink it when there's nothing wrong. Wow. Rigi says, it may be a long journey, but we have Sir Ector on our side. Roraru's father. We will take care of this area. Please go help Gezalg. Batty says, the ground is hard and we can't dig very fast. It may take some time. We should just hit it with his fist. Break through the wall. Siren says, please be careful. We'll do our best too. Roraru's mother. If you get the chance to see Roraru, please tell her that her father and mother are doing well. Kiska's mother. Is Kiska being troublesome to the elder? He is very restless. I get worried about him. Yeah, he's kind of like that. He should punch it with his special fisty-fisty power. Like the perfect application for that. Let's see if people say anything new. I know the vendors won't say anything. Yeah, nothing new here. That's the building we just came from. We like to wander around. It's fun. Get back to U stations. All right. So are we supposed to go back to Gezalg then? What's the exchanger? I thought he said like on the left or something, but I don't see anything over there. That guy again. I'm afraid I was reading, but not absorbing. Oh wait, I see it. Sniff sniff. Forte says, this panel here is different from the others. This is probably the escape passage. Now what? Now I'm gonna save. Hey, if we go in from here, the guards will find us. Yeah, you're right, says Forte. I just wanted to see if they'd say something. Alright, I guess we're going back to Gezalg. Oh, well, that's not a place I can go. Ah! So I just fight him. Nah. There's a lot there. Oh, what's going on here? McBain says, there's a soldier. We shouldn't avoid creating any unneeded commotion. We should not avoid creating unneeded commotion? We shouldn't avoid it. So he says we should create unneeded commotion. Alright, let's go cause some... I want to do what you say, McBain, and create unneeded commotions or whatever. Is there another way to go? Boy. And I'm knocking stuff all over the place. Hold on. Okay. I use a wired gamepad. And the wire likes to knock stuff over. So we can't go that way, but is there another way to go? I didn't think so. Hope we're not going back to the... Yeah, we're back here again. Okay, it's Cleda. Yeah, keep moving. Can't get through there. Dead end. Okay, so this is another one of those. Is it a big rock? I'll try to go all around it. Oh, it ends there. And up here is the guard that we should not bother. No, this Cleda. I mean, I don't see a way to go through this. Nothing here, right? There's gotta be some hidden way or something. I think McBain uses rock crash or whatever. Yeah, this just goes around. Alright. How do we either get past the soldier or find another way out of here? Back to the town. Gezalg. Looked like that was on his head. I'm gonna call an episode here, guys. We're gonna ruminate on this and try to figure out how to get to where we're supposed to go. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.